Hey, what's up? So, I just read a comment, and I haven't posted on this channel for a while, but this comment was interesting enough that I want to answer it in video form. So, hey, what's up, guys? It's Breezy. It's been a minute. Hope you're doing well. And I am an INFP. And so the question, I'm just going to paraphrase here. And by the way, before I, you know, paraphrase you, you said, like, if I do this video, I'm going to get lots of views and subs. I don't care about that. What I care about is making something or talking about something that is actually interesting to me, which is, you know, fairly difficult to find topics sometimes, which is, you know, a big reason why I haven't posted on this channel for a while. I haven't really been interested in MBTI at all, so I haven't really had a purpose for this channel, but I have another channel where I post different stuff. If you're interested in following me still and seeing the type of content I make, then I'll post a link to it in the video description. Anyway, so the person asked me to talk about the differences between an INFJ and an INTJ. I think, you know, people ask this question because there's a lot of mistypes, you know. People are unsure whether they're an INFJ or an INTJ. And ask somebody you know very well, like a close family member or a close friend. And they should be able to give you an immediate response to this question, okay? The question is, can you come across as arrogant to new people you meet? Or, you know, just in general? If the answer is yes, and the answer is also, you know, more often than not, you're an INTJ. INTJs have this aura of arrogance. It's like, it's more than confidence. It's like you're confident, but you're also kind of like snobby about it. But with that being said, when you get to know the INTJ, because that's usually, from what I've experienced at least, when I first meet an INTJ before they know me very well, you know, before we've gotten to know each other, they come across as they have this arrogant aura to them. But once we get to know each other, that falls away. And the INTJ is actually a very caring friend. INTJs can be very caring friends in the same way that INFJs are, except INTJs are much less apologetic about it. And INFJs will constantly, you know, be checking with your feelings. Like, are you doing okay? Are you feeling okay? I'm sorry if this upset you. I'm sorry if this. INTJs, they don't give a shit. Think of INTJs. So INFJs are FE users. So other people's feelings and like group harmony is important to the INFJ. The INTJ is an FI user, like an INFP. So they aren't focused on group harmony. What's important to them is their own personal feelings and values on a situation. So instead of checking with the group, instead of checking with, you know, how everyone else is doing with situations they are in, they check inwardly with themselves. Am I okay with this? Does this go against my values? INFJ does not do that. INFJ will always be definitely more focused on others. INTJs don't like to lie, but they lie all the time. they will tell you that they don't like to lie, but they fucking lie all the time. So I don't know what's with INTJs and trying to convince themselves that they don't like to be a liar. But they're a huge liar. So don't believe it when they say that they don't like to lie. They do. They lie all the time. INFJs they actually genuinely don't like to lie. But, and when they do, it's usually not noticeable unless you know them super well. I could pick up on it, but only because I would think about it like 6 years later and then realize it. I never realize it in the moment. If an INFJ has lied to me, I will know about the lie like 4 or 5 years later when I think about it like randomly one day. I'll start thinking deeply about this situation and then go, they were lying. But it takes years to fucking come up with this. And INTJ, they probably lied to you about what they had for breakfast. They probably lied to you about what they did yesterday. They pretty much probably everything that's come out of their mouth is more than likely a lie. I'm kidding. That's a joke. That is a joke. That's just me fucking with you INTJs. But you guys do lie more often than I feel like you should, because you guys are one of the only types that like to go out of your way to tell people that you don't like to lie, which is fucking weird, you know, but it makes sense, you know. Of course the liar is the person who wants to convince other people that they're not one, so, you know, I guess that does make sense. So, I'm trying to think of other things, you know, but that's probably the big things, the big importance differences that are going to be pretty easily noticeable on a person. An INTJ might be a little bit more fit, like, body-wise. Like, an INFJ is more likely to just be, like, skinny. You know, like, just normal skinny. Unless they're in a relationship. If they're in a relationship, INFJs gain a little bit of weight, I've noticed. Especially if they're in, like, a long-term relationship, they gain a little bit of weight. But if they're not, they're usually really, like, almost borderline unhealthy skinny, but they're okay. INTJs are usually a bit more muscular. They usually like to take care of themselves a bit more. They like to look a little bit more sexy. I guess that's the best way to say it. INFJs aren't as concerned with looking good to others. INTJs, they want to be presentable. They want to present themselves as attractive, because the type of partner that an INFJ, I guess both types are attracted to, are they're attracted to the type of partners that are into, like, they're attracted to SE users. So that should tell you everything you need to know if you know anything about MBTI. They're attracted to SE users. So, of course, they want to look attractive. Now, an INFJ usually does not care about this at all. at all. INFJs are confident looking how they look. Which just by itself will attract the SE user, you know, but the INTJs do take the extra step of maybe exercising, going to the gym, getting their hair done, you know, just doing those extra things that the INFJ probably isn't thinking about unless it's a super, super important thing for an INFJ, like a super important date, super important event he's going to, she's going to. I mean, INTJ is just typically more inclined to be worrying more about their outer appearance. And what else? Thinking that's all I can think of that's going to tell you the big differences. If I think of anything else, I'll put it in the comments. Anyway, guys, it's been Keto. It's nice to see you. Peace and bye. Latest.